classroom before.
I'm good. That's right. See ya. No? That was good. I told you my kids are good.
Where's your cheese pits? Cheese pits?
Not tonight. Okay. Queso grano.
Seeing none. Well, first order of business is we have board elections.
I nominate John Bird as secretary.
So moved.
Okay. Moved and supported for John Bird to be the secretary. Are there any other nominations? Final time. Any other nominations? Seeing none. All those in favor of John?
Aye.
Those opposed? Congratulations, Brother Bird. Are there any other nominations? There are no other nominations. Trustee Davis, do you accept the nomination?
I do. Thank you.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Ayes have it.
Mr. Chair, I nominate Joe Booth as vice chair.
Support.
Supported. Are there any other nominations? Trustee Booth, do you accept the nomination? With that, all in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Aye. Ayes have it. Congratulations, Trustee Booth.
And lastly, I nominate Steve Claywell as chair.
Support.
It's been moved and supported. Are there any other nominations? I accept the nomination. Thank you. Schedule of the regular meetings and times, which was in the portal, the trustee pushes.
Move approval of the schedule of regular meetings and times.
Support.
It's been moved and supported. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Ayes have it. Do you have any conflict of interest policy requirements? Board wishes.
Move it close.
Okay. The moves are supported.
Support.
Any discussion? None. All of them favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Ayes have it. Before the board, we have the December 3rd special meeting minutes of 2019. Your wishes.
Mr. Chair, I move the approval of the December 3rd, 2019 special meeting minutes.
For support.
It's been moved and supported. Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Ayes have it. We have the December 20th, 2019 special meeting minutes before the board. Your wishes.
Approval of those.
Second.
It's been moved and supported. Discussion. celebration for us here on campus. We have the distinct pleasure as a board, as a community, to welcome our new president, Dr. Adrian Bennett.
At that time, we were looking at being in a decrease of 3.5% in credit hours and down 3.8% in headcount. In that last week, we had the pleasure of registering almost 500 students. So a report that I ran yesterday shows us to be into the positive, and it's a not quite 1% positive in contact hours, 0.94, 0.21 in credit hours, and 0.57 in headcount. So this is the last week that we run the registration activity. Once we get into the semester, and we'll be on count date for classes, and we'll start actually counting the enrollment, which will provide you information for them.
All right, next we'll move on with the HLC, which is the Higher Learning Commission multi-location site visit result. And I'll ask Dr. Paul Watson to give an update on that.
Thank you. On the November 4th, we had a visit by the peer reviewers from the HLC at two of our additional locations at the Grawl Center and at the Branch Area Career Center. And we received the highest possible commendation for the services that we provide at both of those locations. And in particular, note must be made for all the faculty, staff, students, and in particular, Chris Jenkins over at the Branch ISD, as well as Sherry Devers, the director over at the Grawl Center, for assisting me and us at KCC in making sure we had a clean audit of our educational practices at those two sites.
And also, under Dr. Watson's purview, is the Higher Learning Commission reaffirmation of accreditation, which is what we are preparing for now. So Dr. Watson, can you share?
Absolutely. We are making great progress on our timeline for the completion of that report for the board and the community's review. At this point, we are on track with all the targets that we set last year in February, and we have about 35% of the reports that will form the greater part of the draft report that we will be working on this summer with the assistance of one of our faculty members, Dr. Perkins. So we continue to make good progress, and we're all raring to go to get these things squared away by the end of the spring. But again, I can't say enough about the great team that I have both serving on that from the entire campus community.
Thank you. And next we'll move on to the updates from the KCC Foundation, and that will be provided by Teresa Durham, our Executive Director.
Thank you. Trustees, I'm really pleased to announce that the KCC Foundation's calendar year-end contributions total approximately $373,000. These contributions are from KCC employees through payroll deductions, individual donors, organizations, and foundations. In addition, the college received $200,000 representing the first award of a three-year grant from the Cronin Foundation for the Eastern Academic Center Skilled Trades Project. This brings the total of contributions gifted to the foundation and are secured for the college by the foundation of nearly $785,000 from June 1st to December 31st. In addition, six new funds were established at the foundation in November and December, including the Suresh Family Endowed Scholarship Fund, the Brenda Mercer Memorial Scholarship Fund for Nursing, the Robbie E. Lyman Memorial Scholarship Fund, the Jerry C. and Janet M. Peterson Scholarship Fund, the International Studies Fund, and the Schweitzer Skilled Trade Scholarship Fund. Can't thank enough our community donors and employees for helping to make Bitter Brighter Future Auction and Raffle on January 8th a huge success. This annual employee event raised $10,400 for the Foundation's Beyond Tuition Emergency Needs Fund and the college's Blue and Basket Project. Over 17 years, KCC employees have raised $160,000 from this event to help support KCC students. On the counter, you will find what I call a teaser card, which is like this, about the new Promise program in Branch County. The KCC Foundation, as you know, is partnering with the Coldwater Township Sunrise Rotary to help raise significant funds to support Branch County individuals in their pursuit of degrees in the areas of health science and skilled trades at KCC. This is a game changer for Branch County. In a very short period of time, the program has received financial commitments nearing $100,000 for the endowment fund and are on track to reach a goal of $500,000 in just a few short years. It is an honor to be part of this project with such an amazing dedication by the citizens of Branch County. You'll also find a postcard promoting an upcoming concert on January 25th, looks just like this, in the Bender Performing Arts Center, featuring the Afro-Caribbean salsa band Grupo IA, which is led by KCC professor Ron Mulligan. Funds raised from this concert will support scholarships for English language learning at KCC and at the local nonprofit organization, FOSIS. And finally, it is scholarship application season. Application booklets are now available, both in hard copy and on the Foundation's website. Gold, Key, and Board of Trustees scholarship applications are due March 2nd. General scholarship applications are due March 9th. And transfer scholarship applications are due March 27th. And again, a more detailed report of the Foundation's activities are found on the board portal. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. And the last one, the President's Report, is the brief overview of the scholarships and grants. So the college received $17,583.57 in scholarships and grants over the past month, totaling $309,665.54 for the 2019-2020 academic year. And that's a wrap on that.
Is there any questions of President? Okay. Seeing none, we are under board reports and requests on behalf of the board. I know that most of us are aware. I would just like to make sure that we're keeping Trustee Patrick O'Donnell in our thoughts and prayers. His mother passed away, and we want to make sure that Patrick knows that the trustees are with him during this time, that he could really use us. So please keep that in mind. And with that, I understand that Jalen Taylor, our student representative, had the report on behalf of the students. Mr. Taylor.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chair. You know, for me, I really like the beginning of the semester because it's the one time in the year when you see so many students and new faces and familiar faces, and the staff is just so excited to interact with the students. One thing that's great is that there's so many dual enrollment students this semester, and it's like, yes, you're starting and you're learning, and of course they're like, wait, where do I go? Where do I go? I can't figure it out. And it's great to see staff and also students that are here helping those students find their way around campus. Also, there's so many things that are going on right now. Auditions for the Wiz is starting in a couple of weeks. Our students are working on the Mosaic. I just talked to a representative in the tech club, and they're forming different ideas of what they want to do this semester. So there's just so many things going on at KCC right now, and I really hope those things get highlighted. So thank you. Thank you, Mr. Taylor.
Are there any questions for Mr. Taylor? Thank you, Mr. Taylor. Okay, on the board reports, we have a staff member that would like to address the board.
Thank you, Chairman Claywell and board, for allowing me to speak tonight. First thing I want to say is that the last couple of weeks have been really challenging for the institution and for me personally. This set of events have given me an opportunity to go into some deep reflection about my actions and the impact on the institution. So I want to offer this tonight, sincere apology to the board, to my colleagues, to Dr. Bennings, to students, and to the community for the impact that my actions have had and the reactions that they have generated. steps necessary to repair any trust that has been broken.
Thank you.
Okay, we are to the point of the agenda, which is the first section under public comment. Public comment will be limited to 3 minutes. We will do it in the boardroom first. We will do it by row. So when you are recognized, please go to the podium. I'll give you a 30-second just wave to let you know that everyone will have an opportunity. We will go by row in the boardroom first, and then we will go to the Vinden Theater for comments. There is a speaker. We do have somebody. We will recognize everyone by row. Everyone will have an ample opportunity to speak. We have it streamed so that everyone will have that opportunity. So with that, we would ask that all comments be directed towards the board chair, and we will make sure that everyone has this opportunity. So with that, in the boardroom, in the first row, is there anyone that would like to address the board? We'll start here and we'll work this way. And then we would ask, once she sets back down, we'll have the next one. So just give me a second to get the timer started here.
My name is Kimberly Towski. I am a student at KCC. I love this place. I'd like to comment on the issues that have happened, transpiring from what happened with Jorge. I understand both sides. I completely get it. But it comes down, from my perspective as a student and part of a minority group that does get singled out, he's trying so hard to include the single moms, the ethnicities, the students that are coming from across the seas. Like, he wants all of that here. Maybe it wasn't a good idea for the verbiage on his side, but I, as an American citizen, I don't expect him to apologize for what he said or what he did. Maybe the aftermath of the situation, it has not been good. I mean, Dr. Bennings, it's her first month here. Like, that's a lot of a backlash to come down. But at the end of the day, I support his right as an American citizen to say what he wants to and protest how he wants to, and nobody can take that away from him. And it's frustrating for me to see the backlash from the public, but I completely understand because of his position. You know, calling out a specific group for the Trump supporters, it's not necessarily in his best interest, but because he's the director of equity and inclusion at the college, since this administration has been in office, unfortunately, there's been division across the world of specific groups of people, women, ethnicities, and how do I say this? If you're going to offer our president the same grace, I suggest that we all offer Jorge the same grace, because I hope this is a learning opportunity for KCC as well, that maybe your policies need to be stricter, your contracts, but trying to penalize a man for what he did and said when the same person who is causing issues, the POTUS in our office right now is causing issues for these groups of people, I mean, how can you expect him to support that and to be okay with the things that are happening? And, you know, I voted for Trump, so I'm not being a Trump hater. Okay, so I don't want anybody to think that, but at some point you have to understand that it's double-sided. There's a lot of hypocrisy going on here. If you look at the facts of the situation, he was a man on his own time protesting his First Amendment right and speaking freely on how he felt. And as his position at the college, how can you expect him to be okay with what's going on? How can you expect him to be like, yeah, go Trump, because that's not the case at all. Equity, inclusion is not big in the United States right now, and we need people to speak out against that. And sometimes people's feelings get hurt, but that's a conversation starter that we need to talk about.
Thank you. Before you leave, could you please give us your name and address so we need to communicate? And then as speakers walk up, would you please give us your name and address if there needs to be communication? Thank you.
Okay. You want me to say it out loud?
Please.
Okay. Kimberly Towski. My address is 27 Greenbrier Lane, Springfield, Michigan, 49037. Thank you.
Hal Longman, 72 Robinson Drive, 49017, and welcome.
Thank you.
Glad you're here.
Thank you.
When my daughter was about 4 years old, we sent her down to visit her aunt and uncle. And he was a rather crude man, did not have fancy language skills. And we brought her home and heard this sound coming down the hallway. Hot damn, some bitch, hot damn. And she's pounding on this little goat. Now, 4-year-old girl doesn't have ways to express themselves, and that language is not acceptable, but I'm not going to make an issue of it. But somebody who's in the upper echelon of education using that kind of a language just exposes the ignorance that they have, and somebody that ignorant, I don't want them involved in the education of my children. I wouldn't have wanted my 4-year-old daughter to educate people, and I don't want anybody else who speaks like that, has signs like that, who acts like that, who performs that way in public, having anything to do with the education of children. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to the Chairman Bennings. Chairman Claybaugh, sorry, and trustees, I'm Joni Jones. I live at 530 Sylvan Drive, Battle Creek, Michigan. I've lived there for 35 years or so. I've been in Battle Creek since my dad was recruited by Harry Davidson, who was the well-loved superintendent of Battle Creek Public Schools back in the 50s. Mr. Davidson actually was one of the founders of Kellogg Community College. He had a great vision for this community and for what education could do for all people. So I was honored to actually be able to come here and tell you how much I believe in Battle Creek. I wouldn't have stayed here if I didn't believe in Battle Creek, nor would my family have. Now, there's a lot of rabbit holes that we could go down tonight. We could talk about President Trump. We could talk about freedom of speech. But those are rabbit holes, and so I'd really rather just stick with the facts tonight if we can. Here are the facts. The facts are, number one, Mr. Zeballos chose to attend a protest, that is certainly his right, and take a picture of himself with a very foul poster. That happened on December 18th during daytime hours. I believe the college was open until December 20th for administrators. I believe that was working hours for Mr. Zeballos. Mr. Zeballos serves as the Chief Equity and Inclusion Officer, a newly created position by this college, by this board, as of this summer, and he is funded via our tax dollars. This is a public institution. Mr. Zeballos also chose then to post that picture with the very foul sign on his Facebook page with the settings public. Now that post remained for 2 weeks. I was notified of it about 5 days after it was posted. And I was amazed. I thought I could see who his friends were. And I thought, somebody, a city leader, a board member, will get to him and say, please take that down. But that apparently didn't happen, or perhaps he just chose not to. So at that point on January 1st, I posted, shared the post to my Facebook page because I was that concerned about it. Not because I'm a Trump lover or anything like that, but I thought it was below the dignity of the office. So let me tell you, I prefaced mine with 3 questions. I didn't link it to anybody, nothing. I said, is this the type of language that we taxpayers or you board members expect from a public higher education administrator? Is there not a code of conduct for KCC administrators and employees? What will the Board of Trustees do? This is a defining moment for the college and the community. On your webpage itself, Equity and Inclusion, you speak about fostering civility.
Jones, we appreciate your comment. Ma'am, would you like to speak?
Sorry about writing all this. My name is Kathy Skeldon. My address is 20241 Pine Lake Road, 49014. I have attended KCC throughout my years. I worked at the Federal Center for 33 years before I retired. I would just like to say I have been a taxpayer in the city of Battle Creek for 48 years. and part of our tax dollars go to funding the college. And I think a lot of people are going to be looking at the next renewal millage to see whether we want to support KCC in their renewal millage if something isn't done when the Board of Trustees allows things like this to go if something isn't done about it. Because this is for a diversity and inclusion person. This obviously does not follow whatever parameters you set out for that position. And I worked at the Federal Center. We had a lot of different positions, and we had to apply when we were applying for jobs. It put out all of the job requirements that you had to meet before you could get that position. So I'm sure there were qualifications that were set out for that position, and for him to meet them, I don't think this qualified. Thank you.
Second row that would like to speak. We'll go here first.
Hello, board. My name is Sarah Stout. I've been teaching communication here at KCC for almost 30 years. And it's nice to meet you again. I'm not sure that you're recognizing all the faces because there's so many of us, but it's good to meet you again, Dr. Bennings. Glad to have you here. And I'm not here to talk about free speech. I think Mr. Zeballos' free speech is absolutely intact. I think any one of us should be able to express our views. And I wouldn't want to see anyone chastised or lose their job for their political views. I would never want to see that. My concern as a communication professor is that we teach in our classes that using vulgar language or name-calling hurts your credibility. And we've seen that, just like Kim brought up the president. The president has lost a lot of credibility because of the language that he uses. And I am concerned for Mr. Zeballos' credibility in his role as an equity and inclusion officer. I think it was a big step for him to just speak to the group tonight. I think that was important. But I think that's something that we need to address, because you as the board, in the contract with we as faculty, require that we attend certain meetings with certain administrators on campus. And right now, there are a lot of people on campus who are questioning the credibility in that particular office. So I wanted to bring that up so that we can think about that as an issue as well, because certainly being public with name calling and vulgar language hurts the credibility of the office and of the college. Thanks a lot. Oh, 221 Harper Creek Drive, 49014.
Thank you.
Sorry.
To the board president and all the trustees.
Would you say your name and address?
I'm sorry. Sandy Whaling, 749 Cambridge Drive, Battle Creek, Michigan, 49015. I am a little surprised that nobody has come forward to talk about what Jorge has brought to this community. I have been on a journey of racial healing for probably 10 or 12 years and was thrilled when Jorge came into this community. I cannot begin to share with you what I have learned from him and all the resources that he has brought to this town. This is a town that seems to be struggling ongoing with racial healing. That's too bad. In this day and age, that's too bad. And I think there are so many of us that have learned so much history, current things, about what racial healing is about and how important that is to this community and to our country. I was thrilled when Jorge was hired here. I thought, that is a perfect place for him to be. At an educational institution? Absolutely. We have a lot. You have so many young people, people of all ages, but so many young people coming through this college. And I think it's so important that this institution, we recognizes that we need more racial healing, we need information about racial healing, racial justice. There's all kinds of things under the area that he was in charge of. So I want you to think a little bit. I'm 76 years old. I have two daughters in their 50s. I have three grandchildren. I hear that language all the time. I think it's become more of a norm. Whether that's right or wrong, it's not up to me to decide. I just want you to think about what he brings here. And if you have not been involved with things he's done over the last, I don't know, 7, 8, 9, 10 years, you need to get involved in those things. It's a wonderful opportunity for KCC to continue to be and to be the leader in racial innovation, justice, mercy, whatever you want to call it, in this community. I feel that's part of your job. So I just want you to know what he has meant to this community. It's more than I can ever tell you or I can ever describe. Thank you.
Thank you. No. Is there anyone else in the second row that would like to speak? Okay, we will go to the third row. Is there anyone in the third row that would like to speak? Okay. Is there anyone in the boardroom that has not had an opportunity that would like to speak? Okay. We will go to the Benda Theater with assistance. Is there anyone in the first row that would like to speak?
Sporting the sign